قل من رب السماوات السبع ورب العرش العظيم سيقولون لله قل أفلا تتقون. So Allah is saying, say, who is the Lord of the seven heavens and the Lord of the great throne? And they will say, they belong to Allah. Say, then will you not fear him? أفلا تتقون. So now we talked about the ownership of the earth. But what about the ownership of the seven heavens and the great throne? Allah doesn't even ask about their owner here. Instead, he questions the identity of the Rabb, their Lord or their Master. Who is that that would be taking care of these heavens, you know, nourishing them and sustaining their very existence along with those who reside therein? Keep in mind that all you ever know in this life is the first heaven, just the first heaven. That's the universe. And even that we cannot comprehend. So who can take such a task upon himself? So Allah replies, سَيَقُولُونَ لِلَّهِ. And once again, they will say, Allah. So following this, Allah asks, you know, why is it that there is no fear present amongst you when you claim to know these heavy realities within yourselves? So it is incredible power demonstrated here. Beyond simple ownership, Allah is actively attending to the needs of these heavens, constantly at every second. Heavens on a scale that we can't even perceive. So as the prophetic teaching tells us, our first heaven alone compared to the second heaven is like a ring in the desert. So how can we doubt that Allah will not be able to, you know, fix our affairs in the best form when this is the kind of business He is dealing with? So as believers, rest assured, we are in very capable hands.